Now, the next SEO tip I want to talk about are what are called alt tags. Now, before we actually look at these, let's see why they're important. If you go to Google and do a search for the Google Webmaster Guidelines, this will come up. And if you click here, this will show you the Google Webmaster Guidelines. Now, if you go and investigate the Google Webmaster Guidelines, which is an absolute essential if you're serious about SEO, if you come down here, there's a section that says Help Google Understand Your Pages. And if you go and expand the section here, you'll find there are bits in here about the alt text. So there, for instance, it says ensure that your title elements and alt attributes are descriptive, specific, and accurate. So that's why it's important to get your alt tags right, because basically Google tells you to do that within the Google Webmaster Guidelines. And as always, if Google says to do something, you don't ask questions, you just do it. So what are alt tags? Well, they were originally devised for people with visual impairments. And the idea was that if you had some sort of visual impairment, you could have software that would read the screen for you. And when it came to a picture, it would look to see if there's any information behind the picture in what was called an alt tag, short for alternative tag. And it would then read that information. So the idea was it would help people with visual impairments. Now, Google has supported that and also taken it stage further. So what happens is Google will now read your alt tags to get information about, or try and get information about, what your particular web page is about. So it's very, very important that you use lots of pictures within your website, and each picture should have an alt tag embedded behind it. So let's see how you would actually do this in something like WordPress. In WordPress, if you want to insert a picture, you just go here, Add Media, find the picture you want, this one here, for instance, click on where it says Insert into Page, and you've now got a picture there. So if you wanted to put an alt tag behind this picture, you just simply click on the picture, click here where it says Edit, and then you could have your alternative text, like, for instance, SEO training in Perth. I run SEO training courses in Perth. And if I just click on update, you don't see it here. And if I click on update here and preview it, so if we preview that page, you don't see it as such, but Google reads that information behind the page. Again, if you're using WordPress, you've got these two tabs here. One is visual and one is text. So I click where it says text here, you can see this is the code behind the page. And it's inserted this alt text, alt tag here, and the alt tag says alt equals, then enclosed within inverted commas, SEO training in Perth. So that's exactly what Google will read. Again, if you really study the Google Webmaster Guidelines from end to end and really get to know them off by heart, very soon you'll come to realize that what Google likes above all else is text. So this basically is a way of giving Google some text to supplement the information about a picture, because Google doesn't really understand what pictures are about, at least not yet, anyway.